Hi everyone. We're back with more Pathologic Classic. Let me switch over.
Allow me to remind you that an epidemic of unknown origin has already eradicated a few genuinely distinctive towns in the northern part of the country. The cause and circumstances of these tragic events remain uncertain. There is a lot that we cannot explain yet. It appears as though the plague has a mind of its own, as if it is driven by some irrepressible will. Why else has no one managed to fight it successfully? Why does it target the most precious aspects of our existence? The sand plague picks its victims fastidiously, and the same principle always draws it back to whoever tries to oppose it. Surprisingly, we've yet to hear a single word from the powers that be.
All right, let's actually watch this time, because I don't think we saw it at the other one. So we're still on day one. I'm hoping to finish with day one by the end of the stream. Dr. Tikowski's fucking shoes kill me every time. Okay, there we go. Alright, we were just about to talk to Vlad.
I can't breathe. Not enough air.
Vanjula Jankowski, of course. Who else could be so dapper? I've heard quite a lot about you. Have you taken a look around? Be sure to check the state of the industry around here. We have our own ways. You think I've come to inspect this town? Come now, that's precisely what I'm saying. The sanitary inspection testified last year that the full project is in order. Nothing to conveil at. Have a laugh. Everything is fine. Good for you. I can see we're not really seeing eye to eye. The project is special. Very special. That means common standards do not apply here. So I could be very naive. You have probably mistaken me for someone else. I have nothing to do with your enterprise.
No. I won't believe in some urban killer.
Get finished with my coffee. Yes, everything getting back on track won't be an easy task. Isidore came by to see you last night. Don't try to deny it. But what if he did? Okay, so my thought here is, if we ask, because we're also given this one of, like, what we know, that we know what these things are talking about, which we don't. Pretty sure we don't know what they were talking about too much. I think it has something to do with the kid, but I don't think we're completely aware of what they were talking about. But because of that, I'm thinking that if we were to ask outright, he might not give us the correct answer. Whereas if we ask here, we might get more in depth. I am also aware of what you two have been talking about. All I want to know is why he left to see Simon afterwards. Oh my, pray forgive me. So he wants to bring me to heal, that traitor, that bastard. Well, what he asked for was me to stop the factory. How could I not kick him out? There we go. There's the answer that we were skirting around. Reasons don't really matter because he's dead. What did he tell you? Who else could he have spoken to? Perhaps someone who could take measures. Of what kind? Huh? That, my dear and respectful friend, is none of your business. My property, like I said, is in order. See the skin and meat delivery reports. Do you know how hard? No way. It's my bit made, whether anyone riots or not. And I'll have my way with them. I'll find everything out eventually. Alright. That was... Whoops. Again, I have been playing so much Oblivion, so let's see. Nope. Oh, those are the days. I want to do tab for everything. Let me just make this a little easier. What is tab? Okay. I want to do R just because I've been playing so much Oblivion that it'd be easier for me to just work with it than against it. Okay, fine. I'll just work with it. Or against it, rather. There we go. Okay. Cute. I'm called Big Vlad in this one. Vlad the Heavy. Now he's Big Vlad. I don't think he was murdered. How could he who craves monocracy not perish? He couldn't, not in this place. Balance requires equilibrium. So Simon's course of action contradicted yours? Come now, what I'm saying is, when someone takes too much upon themselves, they always end up ground down. That's how life works. But there were signs of an otherworldly visitor that night, was there? Simon has lived a very long life. Very long. He was a worthy man. But long doesn't mean eternal, does it? No one is to blame for his death. Examine the body, you'll see for yourself. It just happened. Cain won't let me examine the body. Well, that's temporary. Family tradition. He's not lying to you. He truly believes Simon was murdered. Were he to admit that Simon simply died of death, he'd probably go to his blast home himself. The shock would be too much for the man. Oh, I see.
Why are my children like this?
I said that at death. What are you playing? What is this manner you're talking about? Be so kind as to mind your own manners. I had nothing to do with it. Don't they say Isidore was murdered by a step demon, a Shabnakadir? There was that thingy, a talon they fished out from the wound. Yeah, so I know Age Bomb like made fun of this one, but like this one's not like these both suck, I think. Okay. I can take this from Cupid Weirdo, but you, a respectful negotiant. It's hard for you to believe, isn't it? It used to be hard for many. Take my boy, for example, a scoffer if I've ever seen one. And now even he believes it's real. He went off his head a bit. You're in the step now, esteemed sir. Eastern and backwards. The dead rise from their graves here. Play dummies dance in bold talk. Does he know this stuff well, that son of yours? He rubs elbows with the rabble, butchers, adongs, shepherds, and gatherers, learns their tongue, collects their legends. He doesn't keep them in check at all. They even dare to come visit him within the premises of the town. If you see a worm creeping through the streets, he's definitely looking for my son. We all know Dinkowski's not any better. That is the pot calling the kettle black right there. Okay, sorry. What's wrong with them visiting within the premises of the town? They're dangerous, they're aggressive, and they hate everyone who isn't a step person. They'll jump you and kill you on the spot. They'll tear you up with your teeth and devour your flesh while you're still throwing this at them. Set their spot within the town. Your measures are to be taken. So what of your son? Perhaps you could tell me more about this creature. Hold your horses. You want to talk to my blockhead? No, you're having nothing to talk about. He's not here, thankfully. I don't want you to meet. You heard me? These are tradesmen's words. I'll stick to them. Yeah. Oh, yes, that'll please. No, go behind the back. Alright. We just need to take a picture of this and just keep it up. This is the one where I have to follow the dog. I think I remember that after we finish following him, he starts attacking. So I think we're just gonna, at that point, we're just gonna run in. Good time to drink some water. Stay hydrated, everyone.
Katerina thinks Claire is a messenger from heaven. Yeah, right.
You found me here. Oh, well, I'm not surprised. I suppose you're not too surprised by the fact that everyone knows about you either. The rumor of your arrival spread like fire. Why have you come? I've come for some sightseeing. There was a peculiar incident yesterday by the stream. The children were playing in the mud as usual, but then suddenly they ran away from the sandbox. Their parents noticed that their hands were smothered in blood. However, none of them were wounded. Neither were any of them surprised. How's my volume? Okay, good. What's the solution to the puzzle? When the worried adults came to the place where the children had been playing, they found nothing unusual, only sticks and stones. What do you make of it? Our children play peculiar games. Nice to meet a person of a skeptical mind. I'm Vladislav Ogimsky, the younger one, of course. And you are, of course, Mildred Kofsky. Nice to meet you.
There's this thing that needs to be done.
Actually, I have news for you that should prove to be of interest. You seem to be looking for the killer, right? Listening. I'll have to briefly explain a few things to you. Have you already been told what the termitary is? I'd like to hear you describe it. The termitary is a huge bunkhouse where the Bull Project workers live, although living is the wrong term for it. They nest. They're nesting as a commune with a rather simple way of life. It could without reservation be called savage. And let's get to the point then. The case of pointless, aimless unrest has occurred in that hive mind's nest. The workers there are prone to lashing out from time to time, like beasts frightened by a storm. They rage, they howl, they gnaw at one another, an unsightly image of mass uprising. And that is exactly what's going on there right now, isn't it? Precisely. Why are you telling me this? Riots occurred in the cemetery several times before. The mob goes crazy for a few days, then they calm down just as unexpectedly. All of them out front, the sudden calm is just as void of reason as the unrest that has set the Magog priest ablaze. Having a certain experience with the kin, we simply block the entrance to the seal off until the riot defeats itself. Yeah, you know, no reason for them to riot. They just, you keep them in this building. We'll lock them up and then they, they'll calm down. Yeah, yeah. You know, no reason for them to riot. God. And we usually lock them up beforehand. The evidence of an upcoming outbreak of mass lunacy becomes obvious in advance. And the Termitary's father superior informs us of it. The father Tai Chi has recently passed. A curious coincidence, don't you think? Not the anarchy. Anyway, a member of the kin managed to run off into the town while we were busy taking measures. Is the killer? I think you and I can help each other, Doctor. You are looking for the killer, and I'm sure it is a runaway butcher. The title of a half-man suits him very nicely. The Canes claim that Simon had not been killed by a human hand, don't they? And our family does not need unnecessary unrest in the town. The butcher can battle the devil knows what. His mind is mostly clouded with insane ideas. So you'd rather you tell Mom about what has happened inside? You are correct. They barely know how to speak, but that only makes it worse. Half-men, half-beasts. They start preaching and feel as though you've encountered a doomsayer. And you're this butcher to disappear. And some of the kings are simply killing if the beast attacks you. The reward would be hefty. Yeah, like... gonna fucking murder you too? Are you taking me for a thug or something? I'm taking you for a person that's looking for the killer and has authority to punish him. I'm telling you, there's a rebellious outlaw beast out there. If he attacks you and you're forced to defend yourself, you're free to kill him. Yeah, I think your family has me send someone who is a better killer than me. If there's
Katerina thinks Claire is a messenger from heaven. Yeah, right.
I'm gonna have to figure out if I'm actually gonna read everything, because, like, my throat is not meant for this. I probably just usually talk about, like, this amount normal day at work, but I haven't been to work for 3 weeks now, and I am out of practice. How it all turns out. I used to keep this place secret, but all these secrets seem so childish now. But now tell me, did Isidore visit you last night? Tell me the truth, please. Yes, Isidore did pay me a visit, but don't ask what he talked about. I have no right to share that with you. I'm going to ask you one more question now. Your answer will determine whether you and I become friends or enemies. Well then, I'd rather be your friend. Go ahead. What did you talk about? Tell me the truth, please. Isidore said, note that I'm merely telling it secondhand. He said there's an epidemic in the Seth camp. An outbreak of Charbagon sickness, perhaps. The plague, that is. Father had issued an order to block the Termitary up to prevent the infection from getting in. Do you think Isidore had already been infected when he spoke with you? He was wrapped in a cloth that smelled of alcohol. He said these were preventative measures. But I still think he could have done all that just to convince me, after failing to convince my father. This idiotic is me to fall for it. So he could have already been infected when he visited Simon. We need to warn Lupin. It's very urgent. He's about to examine Simon as soon as the period of time required by the king's passes. Where is he? I have no idea. Where is he staying? I don't know. There was a secret dissecting room in one of the warehouses, but no one knows where exactly. He still lives mostly in the steps. Sometimes sleeps in the Termitary or at Lara Rebel's shelter. He's not there, I know that for sure. He went away to warn his master. What would you have done if you were him? Now let's just check every warehouse. He said he was in one of them. Here it is. See, I found it. That was the door. That's the door, which looks exactly the same. Like anything that helps take. Oh, we passed it right. Trunk. No, you don't even have anything. Oh, that is not what I meant to do. Not here. long is he not here? They have flyers outside to tell you which ones to buy on.
A part off sent to the well is broken at last.
Welcome, welcome to your guest. Give the man something to drink, let him grab a bite, sit down comfortably. You should have a big city guest of respect. And don't let him out talk to the other. Oh, credit cards, dice. They think big city, but the game's pretty gritty. I have fun with my money, thanks. Since we've just met, Doc, you go in peace for the first and the last time. The next time you exit, it'll cost extra.
Yeah, that ain't no simple lance. You got a keen eye for playing tricks.
Alright, he'll sign him. You think I did? I'm not thinking anything, I'm asking a question. Asking, huh? How could a man that's been fooling around with them that afterworld shenanigans not done? Ain't nothing good about sticking your nose to where us humans are neither welcome nor wanted. Don't trouble trouble until trouble troubles you. Right, Doc? Do you think Simon's been killed by a supernatural creature? No one is to blame for his death. In common to this dock, it was. You tease death, I'll snatch you up. I've seen some shit. I've got some experience, mate. You know what I'm saying? Simon did tease this, so he saw it coming. Show me who's blaming a man or a ghoul for it, and I'll spit him in the eye. You only say that because you know, Let's use the street hysteria. Woman getting killed? Are those your men at work? God, this song is so good. No, but my hopes are only catching tiny little fish in muddy water, nothing else. Would they go looking for trouble at a time like this? Why would they cut beggars in? The ones that after them girls in the street or your aunt is working scared shitless. Got themselves hung over twine rings that themselves grim fear knocking on the back of their neck and been fashioned the same ago. That's all the time happening. Well, you've got to keep looking. You'll find yourself a killer, Doc, you will. In fact, now we're spawning 10 more. You're bound to catch at least one by the end of the day. Sorry to leave. Yeah, but still need to find stuff up. Seriously? where else we're going to be. I'm gonna go check back there. And then if he's not there, I guess I'll go to Laura Rapp instead. He's still not here. Oh, that's Laura's. Assembly is an ace that has me solving it on a map.
I think I'm fading. My clothes are worn into holes.
Yeah, I was hoping I came to Marriott to an hour ago. I recognize the street way. My name is Laura Rapp, and this is the shelter. So, always welcome here. My name is Vanessa, and I'll be in coffee. Let's be friends now. I prefer being friends with everyone. You always have guests, but your face looks bad. Oh yes, I'm in the gym. this house after all. That doesn't mean I'm a mistress, mind you. Not with a capital F. I won't ever become one, but I can serve people to the best of my ability. Who are the capital M mistresses, then? The mistresses of the town. We call them demon mistresses. Kena, Olgasai, and Sabarova. Now, after Victoria's and Nina's departure, their daughters who are trying to see the future. They are far less impressive than their mothers for now, of course. Maria is probably the best. Equivalent of their timing. The things you'll see here are not subject to comprehension. They'll burst into your everyday routine like the horrors of your childhood that have come to life. They'll thrash your logical thinking and disrupt every single part of you. The sharp mind of an analyst won't be able to wrap around them. You can't even imagine. I can imagine this very well. That is what I have the sharp mind of an analyst for.
It's nice to see you.
I know you're a doctor. A wonderful one at that. A celebrity medic. Everyone in our small town knew that a famous doctor was coming here. I'm very glad you have, because I want you to do a certain good thing. Can I ask a favor of you? A few years ago, the travel death rate went through the roof here. People died in a week. 10 or so came down with serious illness. They made us worried, but unfortunately, we couldn't find the cause straight away back then. In the end, it turned out that children were dying because of the game. The world. Kind of a game kills children. They were playing, what did they call it? Well, it was some kind of medical game. They were stealing medicine from the adults and making some diabolical mixture out of it. And they healed each other with it. Back then, the game just faded into obscurity, but now I've heard they were contemplating doing it again. Someone has already been poisoned. What can I do? I'm no poison specialist. I can do an examination, of course, but... No, it's much simpler. There is a house somewhere in the town, either abandoned or just unoccupied. That's where they paid the hospital. That's where they store their horrible mixtures. Please, use your same thing and your celebrity name to put an end to this game. Hello, Gimsby's daughter, believe that the house will be unlocked today. Yeah, these are Gimsby Schmatters, and they can cure plague, so, of course, we have time for this. Capella mentioned this next to one of the ruins. My friend couldn't hear it properly. Have you seen those stone stairways to heaven? I think you might even be able to see the house you're looking for from Eva Jan's window. Most importantly, it should be unlocked. The people around here have believed their doors unlocked. In exceptional cases or emergencies, yes, we do. But generally, houses are supposed to be locked up, occupied by several families. People aren't that scared of losing their own belongings. They care about their neighbors. And now that everyone's so afraid of the manager, of course, everything's locked. In that case, it won't be too hard to find. Around here? No, he's asked out. Reuben.
They say Ripper was caught.
Yeah. you'll see it. Yeah. This is it here, which will lead us very nicely to go searching for Luke. Hopefully you can't see it. My computer kind of blasted off into the stratosphere. I don't know why it's the set top of the game, but it was doing the same thing with Oblivion last night. I guess knock on every door, like every door handle, see if it's unlocked. Let's pop a quick save here in case I lose a lot of time. I didn't overwrite anything else. I'm curious how you find this, please. Children are funny creatures, half human, half something else. But any world is off limits to the adults. You can't see our real faces, just as you can't touch our dreams. which is harder to use these scary heads. But how does it all work? See how it all works? Yeah, is this your best idea for jokes, my pants? Maybe smart pants? No way. My pants are much smarter than mine. My head's been lost in the tower. I don't need it here. What are you doing walking around here, walking around having fun? Playing here. Rehearsing, actually. I was looking for something. You need it for the game. Nothing special, just some junk. Try again. And try to be honest with you. Yeah, well, it can't be fixed now anyway. Alright, I'll tell you. Who knows, maybe you'll perhaps you'll even be of help. The kids are in danger. You've come here to get Schmouder. Someone else has already looted the cash. Are you with Alice doing? She's probably distributing them among her minions and taken. Capella, tell me about her. Well, Capella is Capella. Even though she's our foe, we still suspect her. She's throwing kids out of the tower, trying to organize a theft of some kind. And we worship her, like, for real. Oh, well, that's not true. She's the kind of girl you could even fall in love with. Too bad she's not on our side. Of the river, that is. Pride is the downfall of everyone. So what you're saying is she's distributing the Schmouders among the kids, right? Still a woman to fight epidemic again. They won't want us to get their hands on these damn Schmouders so very much. So now we need to catch the kitties. I mean, all the kitties in town, one by one. And pry the Schmouders from their hands. See, the common opinion is that Schmouders can cure all kinds of ailments and stuff. But in truth, they're deadly. Well, it's just kind of beyond. Sort of doctors and hospitals and crap. Do you know how few solars have? What about the Schmouders? An adult will be severely poisoned. They'll be bedridden for a week or so. And that's it. It fills a tomb for the kids. All children are supposed to be cured. Children? All children should come to our polyhedron. We'll be safe there. Oh, you mean that odd structure next to the crucible? Please don't tell me someone's living in there. Secular tower on the other side of the river. There is no death, no grief, no boredom, no disease there. That is proven for certain. Only dumbheads live it voluntarily, if you ask me. You have to be an absolute thick and heartless creature lacking any semblance of imagination to do something of the sort. I get the general gist. So there aren't any Schmouders here? Oh, there's something. I'll take it. No Schmouders. Some protective equipment. I select valuable thoughts back in my books so I don't lose them along the way. Here's people waiting. Quite nice to see. You aren't just hanging here, you know. We're on a combat mission. Well, we're in that utility equipment. So. How are we supposed to know? Supposed to find the Schmouders now? We seriously need to detain every local kid in the street. What should we bargain with them for? And we can't take the Schmouders by force. Blowing against the rules. Han would totally bite our heads off of that. Who's Han? Han is our leader. He's the commander-in-chief and steward of the secular tower. Which one? Polyhedron. Tower on the other side of the river. You won't be allowed in. You're not one of us. Obviously understand a single Schmouder. have to check here, I guess. Mission is still active. I don't see how. You know? I guess there should have her. Okay, yeah, completely upset. The price is wrong tomorrow. I think it's like a ton of money. Just spend everything. Well, a few more of these. I don't know how much we're going to use. There we go. I'm going to need that food later. We don't have to definitely spend all our money right now on food, but I think it'll work out. Stop a safe flight, indiscriminately just making on everything. Every single door. I'm leaving. Well, I thought it was just a as well just looking at the locker about where to find him. Yeah, I'm just gonna look this up real quick because otherwise I'm gonna spend forever just looking everywhere. So you should be with Griff. This is fucking check. Check better. Nope. Okay, let me. Someone else was saying he wasn't there. Victor. I was close. Trying to find the nurse when the nurse on your unit is the supervisor. Are you fucking in there?
time to find me here.
Yeah, it did. Fuck you. Please, friend, I heard news of you alive. Everyone has. Are you here to examine the body as well? I do apologize. I hope you haven't touched it yet. I haven't. Is there a problem? Tommy's body, wherever it is, possesses a dire threat. I suspect he has died of a contagious disease. Are you sure? Well, it doesn't matter anyway. If it's that thing again, what do you think it is? Or something not too dissimilar. What could these steps be home to? I don't believe it. The second outbreak. Wait a second, I need to go to a medical center. Are you sure about this? Do you know what you would say? I am, and I do. If it's the same plague, master steps are so untimely. If it's the same plague, you only have a few more days to live. If you have no idea how to stop, no one does. Mentor has encountered this before. What is the same plague? I'm only making assumptions. I don't want to believe this. I'd rather have any other plague than that. We have no time to waste. The body must be inspected, isolated, destroyed if necessary. We must take protective measures for that, of course. We need a diagnosis before we can provide reasonable protection. The moment you can only buy yellow immunity boosters at the drug stores. They are no good. I'll try to do something about this. We need to take some remedies from old Master's old workplace. Did you know he was murdered by his son? An atrocity. With a weapon in him. Like, and Simon, he's like twisted and everything, like. Okay, what kind of remedies do you speak of? You are unlikely to take them seriously. Let's call it post medicine. Herbs, Eastern recipes, traditional stuff cures, but it works. Master used them during the first outbreak if he survived at least. Yeah, well, someone else probably can't have the first one, 5 years ago. What? Why are your drugstores in such an appalling state? We deliver medicine from the regional center, but there hasn't been a regular train for quite some time. Do you know anything about this, by the way? Perhaps people have some medicine stored at home, but then it's not like we can take it from them, and the stockpiles are empty. Okay, we have another concern at hand now. I'll check your drugstores. That's for you. Please follow your plan. Alright, let's make haste. I'll get everything ready for the examination. Meanwhile, let's arrange for the body to be isolated. Kane is keeping it in a cold place. I'll keep you informed. If we act deliberately and with calm mind, we can prevent this epidemic. Stay strong. I won't leave you on your own. Okay, look how tall he is.
its death at the hand of Simon's murderer. That much is certain.
I've been told of your initial verdict. You assert that Pumpkin was not killed by a human or a shabnap demon, but died of natural cause for some physical sickness. Is that what you're saying? I wouldn't say he died naturally. He died of a mysterious disease. Microbes are more efficient killers than demons. Is that a hypothesis or a fact supported by evidence? Of course it's not supported by evidence. We haven't seen the fucking body. Your hypothesis is not something I'm willing to accept. Furthermore, it seems that it's just widely employed by people who want to hinder the murder investigation at any cost. Same people are spreading fake rumors about civil disorder, which, if they would have it, took over the town. The same people would have simply sacrificed human life to maintain a semblance of order. What would you say to that? It doesn't matter what we think. It matters what he wants to hear. Okay, well, never mind. He would say the opposite and rather say otherwise. The whole narrative must be convenient for those covering his murder. Murderer is going to have to take down his life and keep that secret to himself. What if they do not stop with that? There's the body. No one has touched the body since the death. The tradition kept in our family forbids us from seeing the dead until a certain time has passed. Our experience time will last until tomorrow. But I will not stop when experience looking for the killer until you are able to convince me that your assumptions are true. If he was infected, then how did it happen? Next thing you'll tell me was Isidore who brought that brought the disease into our family home. But thank you. Thank you. For once I fucking agree with Danelle. The most convincing proof will be the body examination. What other proof do you expect? The venerable Ashley, do you take me for some willful old fool who has buried you out of sight? The complicated solution for a simple problem? Or perhaps you think I'm covering some petty else's sin, getting in the way of your doing your duty? You are pushing me towards this conclusion. The body is the focus of the crucible. Not examine it now, I mean that is technically impossible. No one may see the body before a certain period of time passes. Either Master Reuben or you, my dear Master, not even myself. What am I supposed to do then? What can I ask of you now? You have come to a conclusion already, have you not? If you hadn't, then I urge you to seek out the facts as relentlessly as we do. If Providence helps us, we're right. We'll discuss this with your brother. I mean, Victor, obviously.
True way to be deceived.
Okay, never mind. Alright, so think this is as good a time as any to search out that grave where H-Bomb left us some bread and milk, I think it is. Let's see where it is. I remember the first time I found it was took me forever. The key. Yeah, I think it's up there. Yeah, I think we're also supposed to start talking about medical supplies when I see those too. We also want some bread. There was bread. The bread. Hurry. Hurry, where's the bread? Maybe it's over here. I'll take the milk. Thank you, Harry. Okay, got $100 already. right now is she's gonna stockpile supplies for the epidemic. Oh yeah, yeah, there we go. Let's see what happens to the paper. Let's go look for a pharmacy. There, or maybe some sort of store. Yeah, whoever made that can't be bothered to tell you what kind. I think it's a store. Maybe it's not. No, that it is. She's a clothing store. If you turn this way, we'll run into another store and hope it's a pharmacy. Let's start practicing sitting upright. No, yeah, proper posture again, because I can't. Revolver ammo. We'll get a revolver soon. I don't know if we'll ever get a shot. We'll get a shotgun at some point, but I don't think soon enough for this to actually matter. Is it better if you trade for bandages or tourniquets? This I still think could come in handy. I think I'll do it for now. I think we need to also start. I was gonna say start looking for drones, but we can't really look for them, they just appear. I think we might need to find more kids to trade with. We've got some pretty good child money here. Thank you. map can't trade with you. Oh, there's a truck. Man, the kid. There's a jackpot right there. And another kid. The kid gets there. Come here. Why are you running around with... Alright, keep that in mind. And you have nothing, you're useless. You might as well. Good thing we can get it all, which is too. You might as well use it. For food. You have nothing. Nothing for her. Maybe I should have traded the nuts away, but I don't know if she would have even taken them. I don't know what she likes. I need to find out soon, because those girls sometimes have schnauzers. Well, let me see what store that is first. No, just a grocery. Looking at any possible stores. I feel like I'm doing something wrong because I actually have free time, which is much like what I feel at work if I have free time too. If I am bored at work, I feel like I'm doing something wrong. So let me tell you, it was terrible when we had students one time. Usually I love students, I'm going to say that. I love having students. This was one of the days where they each took like 3 people, so that essentially there was nothing for us to do. Which was great, and I should have been grateful, but I hated every second of it because there was nothing for me to do. Not even the extremely boring charting. Problem with being plural. I just did that trade and I can't tell you. I think I traded a laser for immunity boosters. I think I traded some of that collecting some money for that. actually, I take that back. It wasn't from the youth resources for Marigold. Like, I think it was in the I want to see if it's better, but I think it's better. Let's leave it at that. I don't know what to do. You know what? I might as well just take a nap, right? Okay, that brings exhaustion up, though. Yeah, because, you know, I'll tell you, drinking water right now makes me very tired. Going to take a nap with the right first before it definitely is now, and I need to remember to sleep more regularly because this isn't like pathologic too. This isn't like pathologic too where you can only save by a stopping a clock. You can save anywhere in this game. So best remember to save. Moving on, where the fuck am I going? Of course, there's fucking leaves blowing outside. I'm hoping you can't hear it. I don't think you probably can. Yet, anyway. Once they get closer to our fucking window, you probably will. Of course, it has to be today. Okay, that's theater. Good thing all we have is water. Another jump right here. Yep, no. What do you do? Nothing. You meant close. And you don't take any of the things I have. gonna go check that. Just see if I have any water bottles filled before I go check them out. I guess I'll sleep on top of my book. No, let's not sleep 6 hours. Try 40. Something. Not load. And I think all those Rangers get chased by that. I don't think you see any of them on day two. Open. Ooh. Oh, there's all we can get. Fine, as I was expecting. Should probably try eating something, huh? Go try to find Reuben. You go back to Laura to tell her that it's too late. I'm hoping and guessing that this is the last day I'll have time to wonder what I should be doing. Hoping everything else is pretty self-explanatory. It's been almost 2 hours. I think I'm doing slow run of Bachelor Route. Nope, I passed it. Hopefully the other days won't take me as long. So what am I saying? I think they get longer. Now they're at least going right outside the window, I think that's probably fine. It's like, please don't leaf blow. It is pointless, and all it does is hurt the environment and noise pollution for streamers. The leaves serve as good mulch while they decay. It's, you know, free fertilizer, essentially. And, you don't have to use gas if you're not going to waste well. And you don't ruin anyone's dreams. Please stop it. Can you please normalize having leaves on the ground where they belong?
Was it a month ago?
Okay. That was pointless. Where I saved last. I don't understand the order. Now the quick saves are at the top. Yeah, I think I'm going to load this one. Because there's no point going to Lara. So I might as well stay in the area. See if I can find Ruben. Okay. Yeah, alright. Before I had the bread, so let's do that. I haven't even said all off. Not here. Who the fucking talks to Georgi?
Most men only die because.
Right. I'm in the area, might as well talk to Maria. Yeah, I hope the other days I don't have to ask what to do.
Wanted an heir.
All I'm just back where I was. Never mind. I am going around in circles. of spreading anger and forge and diaper at the old expense, at least something will be happening. We'll keep checking stores. I'm trying to think. Maybe I should just sleep until midnight, head to the theater, and then call it a stream? That's the theater. Because my main goal for today was just finishing day one. We're getting there. I don't see the point of, I honestly don't see the point of just walking around in circles like I have been looking for something to do. So might as well get some rest and go see a play. Does the screen keep pausing? It's an interesting question I didn't want to have to ask. I have it popped on my phone, but it's super behind and super laggy, so I don't know if that's just on my end or overall. Like, I keep trying to pause it, but I have to keep it up in case anyone comes into chat. Yeah, I can't pause it. Give me a second. I'm trying to try rebooting it. There we go. Okay, I managed to pause it. There we go. Okay. So I'm hoping that was just on my end. I can find some more water bottles and we'll head back to the Stillwater, sleep until midnight, see the play, and then I think that'll be a stream. And hopefully next time we can just get through all of day two. We don't want to keep having to split these up so that each day is two streams, because that's just too much.
The day is over. Your timely efforts allowed your supporters to remain unharmed. A new mime performance is being rehearsed at the theater.
Okay. You know why I said that? We're hoping for the knife-wielding bandits? No. Load that back up. I think this might be as good a time as I need to learn how to fight, though. We're just gonna, we might just hightail it to the, theater, is my thought, because his safe is, I think I'll let him loot, Hope that this is the correct way. Yeah, and just fucking run. Yep. Yeah, he's after me. So, we're just gonna run to the steamer. Because, fighting is not going well for us. Maybe someday we'll learn, but, that day is not today. Fuck, that's another one. Okay, okay, let's just go around. Alright. Okay, that's drunk. We're good. Fuck. But the music stopped. I thought I was safe. I thought it was. I am not. Oof.
Today, the killer was identified. Its nature turned out to be completely unexpected.
The enemy is found, a name. It's called the Sand Pest. The contagious plague is threatening to ruin everything here.
How can a killer like this be punished? How can a villain like this be struck?
He can't. It's impossible. By pulling a knife on it, you'll just cut an innocent body.
I think I should go. Nothing to be done here anyway.
You should go. Go then. Wherever you please. Shoo.
Right. I think I'm going to call it here. And next time, I can't promise you when. Next time, I think I will head back to the Stillwater. Get a proper amount of sleep this time, maybe like 5-6 hours. And then do day two. So I will see all of you then, and hopefully day two will be more exciting. Alright, let me save first, and I will see you all then. Thanks for joining me.